afternoon, everyone. Some of you know me already, but for those who don't, I'm Al Miller, and as you can see by this large crowd today, I'm just one of Roy's many, many friends. So it is indeed a pleasure to be speaking to you today on his behalf. I don't have as many buttons on my jacket as Roy, but I have one here that's very special to me, because this button was once worn by Roy himself. I was reading his buttons one day at the Home County Folk Festival, and I had a particular interest in this one. So Roy smiled, he took it off of his jacket and pinned it on mine. So I'll treasure it. Roy had quite a sense of humor. This button reads, "If the police ask, I was here with you the whole time." Now, I want you to think back to the very first time you saw Roy McDonald on the street. Now, until you have actually met Roy in person, you may have mistakenly thought that he was just a worthless bum. How wrong first impressions can be. It has been said that the true measure of a man's worth can be determined by the number of people who show up at his funeral. Now, a huge crowd last week at Roy's funeral, and your attendance here today proves Roy McDonald was worth so much to so many. Even the mayor of London was there last week to pay his respects to the mayor of Richmond Row. Sometimes funerals can be pretty sad, but Roy's funeral was different. The room was filled with funny stories and laughter, which made everyone feel good, because we all knew that's exactly what Roy would have wanted. Another thing that happened that I was amazed, we all got to sign Roy's casket, which was something else that Roy wanted. A wise man once said, shortly before he died, "If you can only remember me with tears, don't remember me at all." So when we talk about Roy, when we think about Roy, when we share our happy memories about Roy, we'll all remember Roy with a smile upon our face. Roy always had a big smile for all of us. Roy was single, and I think proud to be a bachelor. He decided years ago chasing wild women was a whole lot better than catching them. He had a great definition of a bachelor. Roy said, "Bachelor is a guy who has a lot of bad habits, but he's still allowed to enjoy them all." Probably one of Roy's most outstanding bad habits was not ever trimming that beard. But Roy just wouldn't be Roy without it. I met Roy way back in 1967. It was Canada's centennial year. And as part of the celebrations, Roy and I were entered in a beard growing contest. Three guesses who won first prize. Roy had the biggest, the bushiest, the blackest beard that you had ever seen. But that was 50 years ago, before he got old and gray. Now, Roy was a bit of a poet, as you know, so in his honor, I'd like to read a poem. Now, Roy didn't write this one, but it sounds like something Roy may have written, because it kind of explains his philosophy. It's called "The Guy in the Glass." Now, you may be thinking it's a beer glass, but no, it's not a beer glass, it's not a shot glass, it's not even a drinking glass. It is a looking glass. It's a poem about a guy looking into a mirror, and it's called "The Guy in the Glass." When you get what you want in your struggle for pelt, and the world crowns you king for a yourself and see what that guy has to say. For it isn't your father or mother or wife whose judgment upon you must pass. The fellow whose verdict counts most in your life is the guy staring back from the glass. He's the fellow to please, never mind all the rest, for he's with you right up to the end, and you've passed your most dangerous, difficult test if the guy in the glass is your friend. You may be like Jack Horner, pick out a plum, and think you're a wonderful guy, but the man in the glass says you're only a bum if you can't look him straight in the eye. You may fool the whole world down the pathway of years and get pats on the back as you pass, but your final reward will be heartache and tears if you've cheated the guy in the glass. Rory. Rory never cheated anyone. He lived his life, he did his thing, he did it his way. He's passed this test, hands down, with flying colors. Rory McDonald can look into that mirror, hold his head high, and be very proud of the guy in the glass who's staring back at him. And I am proud to have known Rory for so long and to have shared a part of his life. I too have won Rory's stones, which I'll treasure always, because I feel honored and very privileged to have been included as one of Rory's personal friends.